Every year, 250,000 or more women will be given a diagnosis of breast cancer, and about 40,000 of them are expected to die. Cancer is abnormal development. So in order to understand cancer, we really have to understand the processes that lead to normal development, and then we'll be able to dissect those to understand how they've gone awry to lead to the abnormal development that creates the cancer, which is the danger to human health.
A hallmark of cancer is that they have acquired some level of growth factor independence, but they're not completely growth factor independent. They have requirements. They have growth factor requirements. They have requirements to contact their neighbors or contact their matrix that's underneath them. And all of these things might be required for cancers and might be potential targets. By looking in the embryo, we've uncovered a large number of them that are active during these proliferative embryonic stages that we've now found are also active in cancers, and those provide new targets.
We think that some of the signatures that we've identified in these cells, we're going to try to convert them into strategies for early detection. And then, of course, detecting early and knowing what you're dealing with, having the person's fingerprint on their cancer, will enable us to treat that person as the individual they are, hopefully causing minimal toxicity and maximal benefit. What we're really interested in is the translation of our basic research understanding to improve human health, which is what the Salk Institute is all about.